Which one to look at? What do I do?
Forget the two.
Joe, do you remember the one you took at Brian's? The whole table? You had everybody
oh,
in
the
picture.
And they were, right. Like, it was a movie picture.
He's doing it now. I'm doing it.
Did I do that?
Yeah, you got everybody.
You did at our rehearsal.
It was incredible.
Yeah.
See?
Mm-hmm.
That is not an M. Don't be.
Well, Rachel goes here.
You may all be seated. Thank you very much. A perfect lilac day.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that Karen's favorite flowers are how perfect that they're all in bloom just for her. Oh, and I guess they're probably for Joe too. This day is an amazing, amazing day and a very happy, happy day for these two kids. The view itself is pretty amazing. Not too many people get Mount Washington, and it is Martha, not George, that is shining on us today. I don't know how many of you know, but in the state of New Hampshire, a bride and groom need one thing. One thing. Does anybody know what that one thing is? Me. Only me. So, what are you all doing here? We all know why you're here. You're here to celebrate this wonderful day for both Joe and for Karen. Probably the most important step that they've ever made in their whole entire life. And they wanted you to be here. I always feel extremely special and very honored to help a couple become husband and wife. So I want you to share in that specialness because you are special. They wanted you here. wanted you here to witness this wonderful, wonderful moment for them. I know today will be a fun day. A lot of laughs, a lot of music, a lot of beautiful music, actually. A lot of food, a few drinks, perhaps. And if there are any tears at all, I certainly would hope that they are tears of joy. But since you're all here, and I will now hold you to task, I ask you all to just open your heart, just a little part of your heart, and make yourselves a promise that you'll be there on the days that aren't quite so wonderful as today for Joe and for Karen. A bride and groom could ask for no more wonderful gift than that alone. And for that reason, I'm sure, I'm very sure, that's why they want to be here. You know, I know how important this day is for you, Joe, and for Karen as well, but especially for you. Because, Joe, you're going first with everything we do today. You're leading the way, Joe. You know what that means? For the next 15 minutes, you will be number one. So I want you to enjoy the next 15 minutes because it's going to be over after that. I do have to ask a couple of questions, and I'll start with you, Joe. I ask you, do you come of your free will today and with a conscious desire to be united in marriage with Karen?
Yeah.
And will you promise to care for Karen in the joys and sorrows of life come what may, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment in your life together?
I do.
And Karen, do you come of your free will today and with a conscious desire to be united in marriage with Joe? Will you promise to care for Joe in the joys and sorrows of life come what may, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment? I can't think of a more beautiful spot that you've chosen, and especially on a day like today. But you're starting on an adventure today, a real adventure, so not unlike the adventures that our Native Americans started every single day when they headed out in the morning to discover. And these mountains they discovered. They discovered our falls and our rivers, and they named them all. Simple, daring. Their language is part of probably the most beautiful that I've ever heard for its simplicity. And on this day, I'd really love to share a Native American blessing with both of you. So Joe and Karen, now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead and through all of the years. May happiness be your companion and your days together be good and long upon this earth. So, Joe, if you could just take a turn, you'll be back to me and really loud with this.
Okay. To laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
Grow with you in love.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Joe, I take you to be my husband.
Joe, I take you to be my husband.
To laugh with you in joy.
To laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
To grow with you in love.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I have the two of you holding hands. It's far more than a photo op. There's such meaning to a couple holding hands. People don't need words to know that something very special is happening to the two of you right now. It's far more than that. You're also sharing your strengths, you're sharing your weaknesses, you're holding on to one another, and you are now joining two families. So there's a lot to be said for hands. I'd like to do a reading for you on hands that will now trace your hands from this day forward for the rest of your lives. Joe and Karen, these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love, that hold yours on your wedding day. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your future together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and care for you throughout the years. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief torments your mind, and with the slightest touch, will comfort like no other. These are the hands that will give you strength when you struggle, and support and encouragement to chase down your dreams. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children and help keep your family together as one. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow as well as tears of joy. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled with age will still be searching and reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
Karen, with this ring,
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward, you will not walk alone.
You will not walk alone.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
I have no greater gift to give.
I have no greater gift to give.
I feel so honored to call you my wife.
I feel so honored to call you my wife.
I feel so blessed to call you mine.
I feel so blessed to call you mine.
May we feel this joy forever.
May we feel this joy forever.
Now, Joe, that her wedding ring is closest to her heart, could you please seal it with her engagement ring?
Yeah, you can help. Joe and Karen, treat yourselves and each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you here today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, or fear assail your relationship, as they do all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right to you. Not only that silly little thing that at that moment seems, oh my goodness gracious, so very, very wrong. And in this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun in your eyes, remembering that if you lose sight of the sun for a moment, the sun is really and truly still there. And if each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and delight. Further ado, it gives me a great deal of pleasure as a justice of the peace, not only in the state of New Hampshire, but in this beautiful place that you've chosen, to very proudly pronounce you husband and wife, who may kiss your bride. This is when you make noise. And my last little piece of business here, which is my favorite of all, and it's my favorite because I'm the first one to do it. I am so very proud to introduce for the very first time the
very brand new Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Roy.
To grow with you in love.
As long as we both shall live.
Karen, just
your
turn.
Joe, I take you to be my husband.
To laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow. To grow with you in love. As long as we both shall live. I have the two of you holding hands. It's far more than a prologue. There's such
ain't a lot of things in this old world.
From Joe, this is his. It's called a GoPro.
A what?
It's called a GoPro.
GoPro.
That
was beautiful.
It was beautiful, and it's gorgeous out. Oh my gosh, it couldn't have been a better day. This could not have been a better day.
And the flowers.
I know.
Oh
my god, it is so good.
Oh my goodness. Watching them walk down.
Oh, that's when she started.
She started with the flower girl
crying.
Yeah, I saw you.
I like your song choice. Walking down back.
Thank you. Is that Harper on the ground?
Oh
god.
I like her. Here I am, baby.
Hey,
she's having a temper tantrum.
We
went from 1950s to now.
Oh wait. More.
Up next, we have Mike Roy and Roxanne Roy. Along with Mem. Everyone, please put your hands together for Rachel Johnson and Brian Horan.
Thank you. very lucky. I used to go over once in a while and stay. Oh my God, my mom. Yeah. A little while after meeting Kim and just hanging out with her, I don't think he could have found a better person. She actually got on the fly on a plane, like, what was it, 10 meters? And then,
to New York.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's like a 4-hour drive. So, and now all they do is fly across the world together, and it couldn't be better. I'm just glad they're part of the family now. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.